Hello student, today we are going to discuss that is oxidation reaction of organic compounds. In the last class already we have discussed the different reduction reaction of organic compounds. In the oxidation of organic compounds, there are some specific oxidizing agent used which oxidizes organic compounds into particular products. So the nature of product depends upon the nature of reagent use. Let us discuss these things. So mainly what are the oxidizing agents used? Generally potassium permanganate in acidic medium, alkaline medium, then ozone, then periodic acid, that is HiO4, then selenium dioxides. So different types of oxidizing agents are used, but already we have discussed some oxidation reaction of alcohol, aldehyde, ketones in the different chapters, very common oxidation reactions. But today generally we will discuss some important oxidation reactions. Okay, here you see this is aromatic compound, aromatic hydrocarbon having the benzylic CH groups. That means it is attached to alkyl group. This alkyl group must contain one benzylic hydrogen, that is CH. Benzylic CH group must be present in the substituent. Then it will be oxidized by KMnO4 to corresponding benzoic acid. This is called benzoic acids. Okay, this is very important. If the benzene is attached to any alkyl group having benzylic CH group, means this carbon attached to benzene must contain one H, then it will be oxidized to benzoic acid. If it is methyl, if it is ethyl, if it is that is your any dimethyl, any group attached to the benzene which has alpha, that is benzylic CH group, then it will be oxidized to benzoic acid. This is very common oxidation. Okay, R may be methyl, ethyl or any, the result is benzoic acid. Then another important oxidation using dilute nitric acid. Suppose this is your dimethyl benzene, when treated with dilute nitric acids, the product is, here one methyl group is oxidized to benzoic acid, that is carboxylic acids, and other remaining same. In presence of dilute nitric acid, out of two methyl group, selective one methyl group will be oxidized to carboxyl group and other remaining same. You have to remember, this is very important oxidation of dimethyl benzene. Another important oxidation, that is ketone. The ketone can be oxidized by concentrated nitric acid, KMnO4, potassium dichromate, acidic medium, because these are the strong oxidizing agent. It is oxidized to corresponding carboxyl acid. But what are the breakage? In which bond it will be broken? Mainly we have to remember the formula that smaller methyl group, that is RCO group, smaller RCO group will be oxidized. Here smaller means methyl. So MeCO is the smaller, this is the larger. So smaller group will be oxidized to first, it will be carboxyl acid. So MeCOH, this is the smaller group. The remaining MeCH2COH. So you have to remember first that ketone will oxidize in the smaller group. Through smaller group, it will be first bond broken at the smaller group RCO. Smaller RCO group will be converted to carboxyl acid. So this process is called Pops rule. It is called Pops rule. So you have to remember this one. This is also very important, that is oxidation. Then oxidation of alcohol using aluminium tertiary butoxide. This is ATB, means aluminium tertiary butoxide. In presence of acetone, it will be oxidized to ketone. Alcohol, this is secondary alcohol, it will be converted to ketones, and the acetone will be converted to alcohol. That is just interchanging. Here alcohol will convert to ketones and acetone convert to alcohol. So this is called open air oxidations. Open air oxidation, the name of the, that is a name reactions called open air oxidation. Here tertiary, that is your secondary alcohol convert to ketone, and the acetone, in presence of acetone, the reaction takes place, the acetone is convert to alcohol. This is called open air oxidation. You have to remember, alcohol can be convert to ketone and the corresponding acetone which you use convert to alcohol. This is called open air oxidation. Then this reaction, 3-4 reaction, that is called a hydroxylation reaction, putting hydroxyl group in the carbon chain. For here, that is this trimethyl, that is, we can say this is called as if you see that is this CH3 whole 3 CH, this tri, that is, we can say, what is the name, if you write in branch form, that is 2 methyls, we can say that is 2-methyl propane, 2-methyl propane. This 2-methyl propane undergo oxidation in presence of alkaline KMnO4, convert to CH3COH, that is tertiary butyl hydrox, that is alcohol. That is which type of alcohol? Tertiary butyl alcohol. This tertiary butyl alcohol is formed from this 2-methyl propane, and this one putting of or substitution of OH, substitution of OH, so that is called hydroxylation. Formation of this reactive CH will be converted to OH. Similarly, if it is alkene having double bond, it can be oxidized by alkaline KMnO4. It is called also Baer's reagent. It is oxidized to corresponding diol. It convert to diol. This position OH, this position OH, and double bond becomes single bond. We have to remember, alkene convert to diol by alkaline KMnO4. Okay, but if it is acetylene, if it is acetylene derivative having a triple bond, then it is convert to corresponding acid. So this part will be convert to acids. So this is the higher member acid, this is the lower member acid. But if it has only CH, it is convert to carbon dioxide. This formic acid, again it will be carbon dioxide. So you have to remember, substituted alkene will convert to acids, and another part also acid, but as it has only CH, convert to carbon dioxide. This is also very important oxidation. Then already I have told, if it has only both side is alkyl derivative of acetylene, then KMnO4 oxidation only gives ketone. It will convert to ketone. This part will be C double bond O. Here, when you see the difference, alkene converting diol and acetylene having without R group, without substituted acetylene, the product is carbon dioxide. Last part is carbon dioxide, but first part is acids. If it is only no hydrogen is there, if there is no hydrogen, the result will be what? Ketone, C double bond O. So this is also very important oxidation of aldehyde, that is oxidation of alkene and alkyne using alkyl and KMnO4. That is called Baer's reagent. This is called also Baer's reagent, alkyl and KMnO4. But one thing remember, that is a very important thing we have to remember, in presence of acid fired KMnO4 or potassium dichromate, any CH2 group is there, convert to carbon dioxide. If CH group, suppose R, if CH group is there, convert to acids. This will be acid, convert to acids. If double bond is there, it will be converted to ketones. So you have to remember, if only CH triple bond is there, convert to carbon dioxide and water. If RC is there, convert to acids. But in presence of acid fired KMnO4 or acid fired potassium dichromate, it is a very stronger oxidizing agent. It oxidizes triple bond to acids, and all if it only CH, it is carbon dioxide and water. If double bond, that is ketone. If single double bond with having R, that is acids. So like this, you have to remember, this is a very important rules regarding the oxidation of alkene and alkyne derivative in presence of by acidified potassium permanganate or potassium dichromate. Then very important oxidation, that is sixth one, that is periodic oxidation using HiO4 tetraacetyl lead or sodium bismuthate. These are very stronger oxidizing agent. These are also strong oxidizing agent, HiO4. So here you see, in periodic oxidation, first if any aldehyde group is there, then it will oxidize to acid. So first member is formic acid, then this CHOH become again aldehyde, and again on second oxidation become acids. So second is formic acid, second one also formic acid. Then here just you see, but you have to remember, any terminal aldehyde group become acids, and any alcoholic group, it under two oxidation, two times oxidation become acids, and your keto group will be oxidized. But here we can also convert into another way. If it is first oxidation, it is aldehyde. This is your aldehyde, and if you do second oxidation here, if you do second oxidation, it will be carbon dioxide. As it is two oxidation, so it will be CO2. First oxidation, second oxidation, CO becomes CO2, and last one is formaldehyde, and this is one acid. So 1, 2, 3 member of acids. So three member of acids. CO will be twice oxidation becomes CO become carbon dioxide, and first oxidation become aldehyde. So this is the product. This is called periodic oxidation. Just you see, this is one example of periodic oxidation. Here this part will be oxidized, this is will become first oxidation, alcohol become aldehyde, and right side alcohol become aldehyde. But here, as it is antiform, this is a trans one, this is your cis, and this is your trans cyclic. OH group in trans position cannot be oxidized by periodic acid HiO4, because this cannot form a cyclic complex, cyclic product with the HiO4. If you see the mechanism, HiO4 forms bond with 2OH group. So OH group and another OH group of periodic acid loses water molecule, then it breaks, this bond breaks. As it has antiform, OH group in anti, so cannot form bond with HiO4. That's why trans OH group position of any cyclic compound cannot be oxidized by HiO4 periodic acids. So very important this one. Then ozonolysis. Ozonolysis mainly it is taken by two steps. First step, addition of ozone. Then second step is hydrolysis. In the first step, if it is alkene, then you see, if it is alkene, then you add in two position. First, alkene means RCHO is there. Then R2CO means ketone. So it, the nature of product depends upon the group attached to C double bond C. As it is 1R, that is aldehyde. As it is 2R, it is ketone. Okay. But if it is a alkyne, then first the containing R become acids, and free CH group become carbon dioxide. Already I have told you here also, free CH group always convert to carbon dioxide. So this thing you remember, oxidation of double bond, alkene, alkyne using ozone, that is called ozonolysis. The nature of product depends upon the group attached to carbon-carbon double bond and carbon-carbon triple bond. If 1R is there in double bond, that is aldehyde. If 2R is there, that is ketone. And if 1R is there, in generally in alkyne 1R, 1R means that is acids. In case of alkyne, result is acids. If you free CH group, that is your carbon dioxide. Then another very important oxidation using selenium dioxide, SeO2. It is also one oxidizing agent. What are the rules regarding oxidation of organic compounds or keto groups by selenium dioxide? What if compound containing that is methylene group. If a methylene group is attached to keto group, you have to remember this is the rule. If a methylene group is attached to keto group, it will be this methylene group will convert to keto groups. CH2 becomes CO, other group remains same, pH, CO, CO, pH. So methylene group will be converted to keto group, but oxidizing agent is selenium dioxide in presence of acetic acid. If active methyl group is there, this is the methyl group. If active methyl group is there, it is converted to aldehyde, CHO. Active methylene group will convert to keto group, carbonyl group, and active methyl group convert to aldehyde group. This is the difference. So CH3 becomes CHO, already CHO group is there. This is the rule of oxidation of keto compound using selenium dioxide. Suppose here, see, this is your active methylene group, here also active methyl group. Here methyl group, but one will be considered. Methyl group will be converted to CHO group as per the previous rule. So CHO, then other remaining same. Here two methyl group will not be converted, one will be converted, other remain same. So this is the rule. Here you see, here one methylene group is there, one methyl group is there, adjacent to keto group. That is called active methylene group, active methyl group. Methylene group and methyl group attached to CO group are called active methylene group or active methyl groups. Here what happens, methylene group is here and methyl group is here, but here we have to consider the methyl group instead of methylene group. So ME, methyl, will convert to CHO. Other remaining same. Okay, here you just you see, here it is not keto group, it is the unsaturated group. If unsaturated group is there, here also CH2 group is present, CH2 group, that is active methylene group. In this case what happens, the active methylene group convert to hydroxy group, CH2 group will be convert to OH group, other remaining same. Just you see, ME, CH2, CME, double bond, CSME. Here only this active group, this CH2 group become hydroxy. This is the hydroxy derivative of alkene when use selenium dioxide and acetic acid. But here only active methylene group will convert to OH group. Hydroxy, that is called hydroxylation. Here only condition is, it should be only methyl group will convert to OH group. So these are very important oxidation of aldehyde, ketones, using different oxidizing agents using selenium. In selenium dioxide, one important step is we have to find out where is the active methylene group or active methyl group. Active methylene group will be converted to keto group, but active methyl group convert to CHO group. So this is the main difference between the different oxidation of organic compounds. But I will give one homework question to you. You can also write this one. First step, treated with your bridge reduction. First step, you give bridge reduction, you will get A. Then what happens, A we treated with ozone, then hydrolysis, zinc and water. That is oxidation of this A by ozone and zinc hydroxide, hydrolysis, second step hydrolysis. The product is B. So you, this is your homework. Homework is like this. First is ethyl benzene treated with bridge reduction. Bridge reduction generally sodium, ammonia and your ethanol. This reduction of benzene using sodium and liquid ammonia and ethanol, the product is A. A when reacts with ozone, that is oxidation by ozone, forming B. So identify what is A and B. You have to identify what is the structure of A and structure of B. Okay, you complete the questions and send the answer in the comment box, and you will discuss the answer in the next class. Okay. Thank you all.